Gospel of John, Coloring Bible, chapter 6 to 9, Walking on the Water, John 6, verses 1 to 21, Background. John the Baptist has been executed by King Herod. Jesus sails across the Sea of Galilee to find rest, but there will be no rest for Jesus or his men. Beginning in John chapter 6, verse 1. After these things, Jesus went away to the other side of the Sea of Galilee, which is also called the Sea of Tiberias. A great multitude followed him because they saw his signs, which he did on those who were sick. Jesus went up into the mountain, and he sat there with his disciples. Now the Passover, the feast of the Jews, was at hand. Jesus therefore, lifting up his eyes, and seeing that a great multitude was coming to him, said to Philip, "Where are we to buy bread that these may eat?" He said this to test him, for he himself knew what he would do. Philip answered him, 200 denarii worth of bread is not sufficient for them, that every one of them may receive a little." One of his disciples, Andrew, Simon Peter's brother, said to him, "There is a boy here who has 5 barley loaves and 2 fish. But what are these amongst so many?" Jesus said, "Have the people sit down." Now there was much grass in that place. So the men sat down, in number about 5,000. Jesus took the loaves, and having given thanks, he distributed to the disciples, and the disciples to those who were sitting down. Likewise also of the fish, as much as they desired. When they were filled, he said to his disciples, "Gather up the broken pieces which are left over, that nothing be lost." So they gathered them up and filled 12 baskets with broken pieces from the 5 barley loaves, which were left over by those who had eaten. When therefore the people saw the sign which Jesus did, they said, "This is truly the prophet who comes into the world." Jesus therefore, perceiving that they were about to come and take him by force to make him king, withdrew again to the mountain by himself. When evening came, his disciples went down to the sea. They entered into the boat and were going over the sea to Capernaum. It was now dark, and Jesus had not yet come to them. The sea was tossed by a great wind blowing. When therefore they had rowed about 25 or 30 stadia, which is 3 to 4 miles, they saw Jesus walking on the sea and drawing near to the boat, and they were afraid. But he said to them, "It is I, don't be afraid." They were willing, therefore, to receive him into the boat. Immediately the boat was at the land where they were going. "Think about it, talk about it." Jesus fed a crowd using a boy's lunch and then walked across the sea. What do these stories teach us about Jesus? Pause the movie to discuss. "I am the bread of life." John 6, 22 to 46. Background. Whoever comes to him, he will satisfy. Whoever comes to him, he will give eternal life. Whoever comes to him, he will never push away. Come to Jesus. Cry out to him. Jesus loves you. On the next day, the multitude that stood on the other side of the sea saw that there was no other boat there except the one in which his disciples had embarked, and that Jesus hadn't entered with his disciples into the boat, but his disciples had gone away alone. However, boats from Tiberias came near to the place where they ate the bread after the Lord had given thanks. When the multitude, therefore, saw that Jesus wasn't there, nor his disciples, they themselves got into the boats and came to Capernaum seeking Jesus. When they found him on the other side of the sea, they asked him, "Rabbi, when did you come here?" Jesus answered them, "Most certainly I tell you, you seek me, not because you saw signs, but because you ate of the loaves and were filled. Don't work for the food which perishes, but for the food which remains to eternal life, which the Son of Man will give to you. For God, the Father, has sealed him." They said therefore to him, "What must we do that we may work the works of God?" Jesus answered them, "This is the work of God, that you believe in him whom he has sent." They said therefore to him, "What then do you do for a sign, that we may see and believe you? What work do you do? Our fathers ate the manna in the wilderness. As it is written, he gave them bread out of heaven to eat." Jesus therefore said to them, "Most certainly I tell you, it wasn't Moses who gave you the bread out of heaven, but my Father gives you the true bread out of heaven. For the bread of God is that which comes down out of heaven and gives life to the world." They said therefore to him, "Lord, always give us this bread." Jesus said to them, "I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will not be hungry, and whoever believes in me will never be thirsty. But I told you that you have seen me, and yet you don't believe. All those whom the Father gives me will come to me. He who comes to me I will in no way throw out. For I have come down from heaven, not to do my own will, but the will of him who sent me. This is the will of my Father who sent me, that of all he has given to me, I should lose nothing, but should raise him up at the last day. This is the will of the one who sent me, that everyone who sees the Son and believes in him should have eternal life, and I will raise him up at the last day." The Jews therefore murmured concerning him, because he said, "I am the bread which came down out of heaven." They said, "Isn't this Jesus, the son of Joseph, whose father and mother we know? How then does he say, 'I have come down out of heaven'?" Therefore Jesus answered them, "Don't murmur amongst yourselves. No one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draws him, and I will raise him up in the last day. It is written in the prophets, 'They will all be taught by God.' Therefore everyone who hears from the Father and has learnt comes to me. Not that anyone has seen the Father except he who is from God. He has seen the Father." Think about it. Jesus said, "Whoever comes to me will not be hungry." Have you come to Jesus? What are you most hungry for in life? Pause the movie to discuss. Do you want to leave me too? Background. 1,500 years before Jesus was born, God dropped food on the Israelites every morning for 40 years. The food seemed to fall from the sky and was called manna, which means, "What is it?" Jesus explains that he is the real bread that God has sent down from heaven for everyone to eat. Jesus explains how he gives us eternal life, just like eating bread gives our bodies life. "Most certainly, I tell you, he who believes in me has eternal life. I am the bread of life. Your fathers ate the manna in the wilderness and they died. This is the bread which comes down out of heaven, that anyone may eat of it and not die. I am the living bread which came down out of heaven. If anyone eats of this bread, he will live forever. Yes, the bread which I will give for the life of the world is my flesh." Jews therefore contended with one another, saying, How can this man give us his flesh to eat? Jesus therefore said to them, Most certainly I tell you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you don't have life in yourselves. He who eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him up at the last day. For my flesh is food indeed, and my blood is drink indeed. He who eats my flesh and drinks my blood lives in me and I in him. As the living Father sent me, and I live because of the Father, so he who feeds on me, he will also live because of me. This is the bread which came down out of heaven, not as our fathers ate the manna and died. He who eats this bread will live forever. He said these things in the synagogue as he taught in Capernaum. Therefore many of his disciples, when they heard this, said, This is a hard saying. Who can listen to it? But Jesus, knowing in himself that his disciples murmured at this, said to them, Does this cause you to stumble? Then what if you would see the Son of Man ascending to where he was before? It is the Spirit who gives life. The flesh profits nothing. The words that I speak to you are spirit and are life. But there are some of you who don't believe. But Jesus knew from the beginning who they were who didn't believe and who it was who would betray him. He said, For this cause I have said to you that no one can come to me unless it is given to him by my Father. At this, many of his disciples went back and walked no more with him. Jesus said therefore to the 12, You don't also want to go away, do you? Simon Peter answered him, Lord, to whom would we go? You have the words of eternal life. We have come to believe and know that you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. Jesus answered them, Didn't I choose you, the 12, and one of you is a devil? Now he spoke of Judas, the son of Simon Iscariot, for it was he who would betray him, being one of the 12. Think about it. Jesus asked his men, Do you want to leave me too? Have you ever felt like leaving Jesus? Tell us your story. Pause the movie to discuss. Why do you want to kill me? Background. Many of the people are afraid to say they believe in Jesus because they are afraid of their leaders. Some of the leaders want to arrest Jesus and maybe kill him, but they can't, at least not yet. Jesus returns home to Galilee. After these things, Jesus was walking in Galilee, for he wouldn't walk in Judea, because the Jews sought to kill him. Now the feast of the Jews, the feast of booths, was at hand. His brothers therefore said to him, Depart from here and go into Judea, that your disciples also may see your works which you do. James is wrestling with his older brother Jesus and is saying, For no one does anything in secret while he seeks to be known openly. If you do these things, reveal yourself to the world. For even his brothers didn't believe in him. Jesus continues to wrestle James. Jesus therefore said to them, My time has not yet come, but your time is always ready. The world can't hate you, but it hates me because I testify about it, that its works are evil. Jesus is winning the wrestling match with his younger brother James. You go up to the feast. I am not yet going up to this feast, because my time is not yet fulfilled. Having said these things to them, he stayed in Galilee. But when his brothers had gone up to the feast, then he also went up, not publicly, but as it were in secret. The Jews therefore sought him at the feast and said, Where is he? There was much murmuring amongst the multitudes concerning him. Some said, He is a good man. Others said, Not so, but he leads the multitude astray. Yet no one spoke openly of him for fear of the Jews. But when it was now the middle of the feast, Jesus went up into the temple and taught. The Jews therefore marveled, saying, "How does this man know letters, having never been educated?" Jesus therefore answered them, "My teaching is not mine, but his who sent me. If anyone desires to do his will, he will know about the teaching, whether it is from God or if I am speaking from myself. He who speaks from himself seeks his own glory, but he who seeks the glory of him who sent him is true, and no unrighteousness is in him." Didn't Moses give you the law? And yet none of you keeps the law. Why do you seek to kill me? The multitude answered, "You have a demon. Who seeks to kill you?" Jesus answered them, "I did one work and you all marvel because of it. Moses has given you circumcision, not that it is of Moses, but of the fathers. And on the Sabbath, you circumcise a boy. If a boy receives circumcision on the Sabbath, that the law of Moses may not be broken, are you angry with me because I made a man completely healthy on the Sabbath? Don't judge according to appearance, but judge righteous judgment." Therefore, some of them of Jerusalem said, "Isn't this he whom they seek to kill? Behold, he speaks openly, and they say nothing to him. Can it be that the rulers indeed know that this is truly the Christ? However, we know where this man comes from. But when the Christ comes, no one will know where he comes from." Jesus therefore cried out in the temple, teaching and saying, "You both know me and know where I am from. I have not come of myself, but he who sent me is true, whom you don't know. I know him, because I am from him, and he sent me." They sought therefore to take him, but no one laid a hand on him, because his hour had not yet come. Think about it. Jesus went to Jerusalem to do God's will, even though he knew there was danger. Who do you know that has that kind of courage to follow God no matter what? Pause the movie to discuss. Is anyone thirsty? Background. Jesus says he will make his Holy Spirit flow out of us like rivers of living water. But first we come to Jesus to take a drink. But of the multitude, many believed in him. They said, "When the Christ comes, he won't do more signs than those which this man has done, will he?" The Pharisees heard the multitude murmuring these things concerning him, and the chief priests and the Pharisees sent officers to arrest him. Then Jesus said, "I will be with you a little while longer, then I go to him who sent me. You will seek me and won't find me. You can't come where I am." The Jews therefore said amongst themselves, "Where will this man go that we won't find him? Will he go to the dispersion amongst the Greeks and teach the Greeks? What is this word that he said, 'You will seek me and won't find me, and where I am, you can't come'?" Now on the last and greatest day of the feast, Jesus stood and cried out, "If anyone is thirsty, let him come to me and drink. He who believes in me, as the scripture has said, from within him will flow rivers of living water." But he said this about the Spirit, which those believing in him were to receive. For the Holy Spirit was not yet given, because Jesus wasn't yet glorified. Many of the multitude, therefore, when they heard these words, said, "This is truly the prophet." Others said, "This is the Christ." But some said, "What? Does the Christ come out of Galilee? Hasn't the scripture said that the Christ comes of the offspring of David, and from Bethlehem, the village where David was?" So a division arose in the multitude because of him. Some of them would have arrested him, but no one laid hands on him. The officers therefore came to the chief priests and Pharisees, and they said to them, "Why didn't you bring him?" The officers answered, "No man ever spoke like this man." The Pharisees therefore answered them, You aren't also led astray, are you? Have any of the rulers believed in him, or of the Pharisees? But this multitude that doesn't know the law is cursed. Nicodemus, he who came to him by night being one of them, said to them, Does our law judge a man, unless it first hears from him personally and knows what he does? They answered him, Are you also from Galilee? Search and see that no prophet has arisen out of Galilee. Everyone went to his own house. Think about it. Jesus forgives us when we sin. Is there someone in your life you're ready to forgive? Pause to discuss. The Pharisees want to trap Jesus. Neither do I condemn you. Background. The Pharisees bring a woman to Jesus caught in the act of adultery. The Jewish law says such a woman must be stoned as punishment for her crime. To rescue her, Jesus starts writing with his finger in the dirt. What? But Jesus went to the Mount of Olives. Now very early in the morning, he came again into the temple, and all the people came to him. He sat down and taught them. The scribes and the Pharisees brought a woman taken in adultery. Having set her in the middle, they told him, Teacher, we found this woman in adultery in the very act. Now in our law, Moses commanded us to stone such women. What then do you say about her? They said this testing him, that they might have something to accuse him of. But Jesus stooped down and wrote on the ground with his finger. But when they continued asking him, he looked up and said to them, He who is without sin amongst you, let him throw the first stone at her. Again, he stooped down and wrote on the ground with his finger. They, when they heard it, being convicted by their conscience, went out one by one, beginning from the oldest even to the last. Jesus was left alone with the woman, where she was in the middle. Jesus, standing up, saw her and said, Woman, where are your accusers? Did no one condemn you? She said, No one, Lord. Jesus said, Neither do I condemn you. Go your way. From now on, sin no more. Again, therefore, Jesus spoke to them, saying, I am the light of the world. He who follows me will not walk in the darkness, but will have the light of life. The Pharisees therefore said to him, You testify about yourself. Your testimony is not valid. Jesus answered them, Even if I testify about myself, my testimony is true, for I know where I came from and where I am going, but you don't know where I came from. Or where I am going. You judge according to the flesh. I judge no one. Even if I do judge, my judgment is true, for I am not alone, but I am with the Father who sent me. It's also written in your law that the testimony of two people is valid. I am one who testifies about myself, and the Father who sent me testifies about me. They said therefore to him, Where is your Father? Jesus answered, You know neither me nor my Father. If you knew me, you would know my Father also. Jesus spoke these words in the treasury as he taught in the temple. Yet no one arrested him because his hour had not yet come. Think about it. Jesus gave love and forgiveness to the woman caught in adultery. Then he told her to stop sinning. Who do you know that needs that kind of friendship? Pause the movie to discuss. Liar, liar, pants on fire. Background. Jesus calls the devil a liar, a murderer, and the father of lies. Jesus tells some of the people that the devil has become their father. Jesus said therefore again to them, I am going away, and you will seek me. And you will die in your sins. Where I go, you can't come. The Jews therefore said, Will he kill himself? Because he says, Where I am going, you can't come. He said to them, You are from beneath, I am from above. You are of this world. I am not of this world. I said therefore to you that you will die in your sins. For unless you believe that I am he, you will die in your sins. They said therefore to him, Who are you? Jesus said to them, Just what I have been saying to you from the beginning. I have many things to speak and to judge concerning you. However, he who sent me is true, and the things which I heard from him, these I say to the world. They didn't understand that he spoke to them about the Father. Jesus therefore said to them, When you have lifted up the Son of Man, then you will know that I am he, and I do nothing of myself, but as my Father taught me, I say these things. He who sent me is with me. The Father hasn't left me alone, for I always do the things that are pleasing to him. As he spoke these things, many believed in him. Jesus therefore said to those Jews who had believed him, If you remain in my word, then you are truly my disciples. You will know the truth, and the truth will make you free. They answered him, We are Abraham's offspring, and have never been in bondage to anyone. How do you say you will be made free? Jesus answered them, Most certainly I tell you, everyone who commits sin is the bondservant of sin. A bondservant doesn't live in the house forever. A son remains forever. If therefore the Son makes you free, you will be free indeed. I know that you are Abraham's offspring, yet you seek to kill me, because my word finds no place in you. I say the things which I have seen with my Father, and you also do the things which you have seen with your Father. They answered him, Our father is Abraham. Jesus said to them, If you were Abraham's children, you would do the works of Abraham. But now you seek to kill me, a man who has told you the truth, which I heard from God. Abraham didn't do this. You do the works of your father. They said to him, We were not born of sexual immorality. We have one father, God. Therefore Jesus said to them, If God were your father, you would love me, for I came out and have come from God. For I haven't come of myself, but he sent me. Why don't you understand my speech? Because you can't hear my word. You are of your father, the devil, and you want to do the desires of your father. He was a murderer from the beginning and doesn't stand in the truth because there is no truth in him. When he speaks a lie, he speaks on his own. For he is a liar and the father of lies. Think about it. When we sin, we are choosing to be a slave to that sin. Tell a story about a time when you fought against temptation and won. Pause this movie to discuss. I am. Background. 1400 years before Jesus was born, God told the people that his name is I am. Now, Jesus tells the people that he is I am. But because I tell the truth, you don't believe me. Which of you convicts me of sin? If I tell the truth, why do you not believe me? He who is of God hears the words of God. For this cause, you don't hear, because you are not of God. Then the Jews answered him, Don't we say well that you are a Samaritan and have a demon? Jesus answered, I don't have a demon, but I honor my Father, and you dishonor me. But I don't seek my own glory. There is one who seeks and judges. Most certainly, I tell you, if a person keeps my word, he will never see death. Then the Jews said to him, Now we know that you have a demon. Abraham died, as did the prophets, and you say, If a man keeps my word, he will never taste of death. Are you greater than our father Abraham, who died? The prophets died. Who do you make yourself out to be?" Jesus answered, "If I glorify myself, my glory is nothing. It is my Father who glorifies me, of whom you say that he is our God. You have not known him, but I know him. If I said, 'I don't know him,' I would be like you, a liar. But I know him and keep his word. Your father Abraham rejoiced to see my day. He saw it and was glad." The Jews therefore said to him, "You are not yet 50 years old. Have you seen Abraham?" Jesus said to them, "Most certainly, I tell you, before Abraham came into existence, I am." Therefore they took up stones to throw at him, but Jesus was hidden and went out of the temple, having gone through the middle of them, and so passed by. Think about it. Use your imagination to explain what happens to someone who follows Jesus right after they die. Pause to discuss. Born blind. Background. The disciples assumed that babies were born blind because their parents had done something sinful. Jesus explains that some are born blind to bring special glory to God through their disability. As he passed by, he saw a man blind from birth. His disciples asked him, "Rabbi, who sinned, this man or his parents, that he was born blind?" Jesus answered, "This man didn't sin, nor did his parents, but that the works of God might be revealed in him. I must work the works of him who sent me while it is day. The night is coming when no one can work. While I am in the world, I am the light of the world." When he had said this, he spat on the ground, made mud with the saliva, anointed the blind man's eyes with the mud, and said to him, "Go, wash in the pool of Siloam," which means sent. So he went away, washed, and came back seeing. The neighbors, therefore, and those who saw that he was blind before, said, "Isn't this he who sat and begged?" Others were saying, "It is he." Still others were saying, "He looks like him." He said, "I am he." They therefore were asking him, "How are your eyes opened?" He answered, "A man called Jesus made mud, anointed my eyes, and said to me, 'Go to the pool of Siloam and wash.' So I went away and washed, and I received sight." Then they asked him, "Where is he?" He said, "I don't know." They brought him who had been blind to the Pharisees. It was a Sabbath when Jesus made the mud and opened his eyes. Again, therefore, the Pharisees also asked him how he received his sight. He said to them, "He put mud on my eyes, I washed, and I see." Some, therefore, of the Pharisees said, "This man is not from God, because he doesn't keep the Sabbath." Others said, "How can a man who is a sinner do such signs?" There was division amongst them. Therefore they asked the blind man again, "What do you say about him, because he opened your eyes?" He said, "He is a prophet." The Jews therefore didn't believe concerning him that he had been blind and had received his sight, until they called the parents of him who had received his sight and asked them, "Is this your son, whom you say was born blind? How then does he now see?" His parents answered them, "We know that this is our son and that he was born blind. But how he now sees, we don't know, or who opened his eyes, we don't know. He's of age. Ask him. He will speak for himself." His parents said these things because they feared the Jews. For the Jews had already agreed that if any man would confess him as Christ, he would be put out of the synagogue. Therefore his parents said, "He is of age. Ask him." So they called the man who was blind a second time and said to him, "Give glory to God. We know that this man is a sinner." He therefore answered, "I don't know if he is a sinner. One thing I do know, that though I was blind, now I see." Think about it. Search google.com about Joni Erickson Tada. Who do you know that loves Jesus, even though they are suffering or disabled? Pause to discuss. Lord, I believe. Background. The leaders can't discredit the testimony of the healed man born blind. History calls this man Saint Celedonius, who later founded the church in Gaul, France. They said to him again, "What did he do to you? How did he open your eyes?" He answered them, "I told you already and you didn't listen. Why do you want to hear it again? You don't also want to become his disciples, do you?" They insulted him and said, "You are his disciple, but we are disciples of Moses." We know that God has spoken to Moses, but as for this man, we don't know where he comes from. The man answered them, "How amazing! You don't know where he comes from, yet he opened my eyes." We know that God doesn't listen to sinners, but if anyone is a worshiper of God and does his will, he listens to him. Since the world began, it has never been heard of that anyone opened the eyes of someone born blind. If this man were not from God, he could do nothing. They answered him, "You were altogether born in sins, and do you teach us?" Then they threw him out. Jesus heard that they had thrown him out, and finding him, he said, "Do you believe in the Son of God?" He answered, "Who is he, Lord, that I may believe in him?" Jesus said to him, "You have both seen him, and it is he who speaks with you." He said, "Lord, I believe," and he worshipped him. Jesus said, "I came into this world for judgment, that those who don't see may see, and that those who see may become blind." Those of the Pharisees who were with him heard these things and said to him, "Are we also blind?" Jesus said to them, "If you were blind, you would have no sin. But now you say, 'We see.' Therefore your sin remains." Think about it. Use your imagination to explain how your difficulties or disabilities could bring glory to God in a special way. Pause to discuss. To be continued, to read John chapters 10 to 14, or read online at mrmacbible.com.